Sean Carlson is a wife, mom of four, and high school teacher. While staying busy with family functions and school events, she's also been on a long journey battling cancer.
Late in 2013, so December, is when I felt the lump. I went to the doctor and they, you know, ordered the mammogram. 2 days after Christmas in 2013 was when we found out that it was positive.
Positive for breast cancer. She did all the necessary treatments and eventually moved into survivorship clinic.
In 2021 was when we found out that it had come back. My oldest daughter had just recently gotten engaged, and I mean, I have four daughters, and I just wanted to be there for them. We started treatment there in 2021, and everything seemed to be responding well. And Dr. Jones kept his promise. I made it to my daughter's wedding with hair on my head.
But in November of 2022, she started having some symptoms that were out of the ordinary.
She had some odd sensations on her scalp, so it prompted a brain MRI, and it was the first time they had found disease in her brain. On the MRI, we probably saw more than 30 lesions, and they were just scattered kind of throughout the brain.
We were scared because, like, you know, you hear, oh, you're cancer, you've got cancer in your brain, and, like, that's over, you know, that's end game, you know, in my mind.
So the first thing that I did is I talked with Dr. Jason Jones, her breast medical oncologist. We wanted to come up with a way, how do you treat the lesions that you can see on the MRI, but how can you ensure that there's still brain-directed treatment throughout the entire brain to keep any new lesions from emerging?
Dr. Arneson decided to use Gamma Knife to treat the lesions.
We needed a stereotactic frame that actually was held to her head, so we worked with the neurosurgery team for that. When they put that frame on the head with the neurosurgery team, they are given conscious sedation, so they do have some relaxation medicines in them.
They treated 20 spots, which meant that for each spot, I think he said it was like 12 or 15 minutes that the radiation would be on each spot. And so that meant that I was going to be in the procedure for 3 hours.
While Gamma Knife was used to treat the larger lesions, another treatment is being used to bridge the blood-brain barrier.
Our bodies are set up to have this barrier that keeps our blood and our central nervous system separate. It helps to keep it so we don't have infections and other bad toxic things that cross over into our brains and gives us quite a bit of protection. Now we have new HER2 medicines that actually, for a specific type of breast cancer that is HER2 positive, that actually crosses the blood-brain barrier very well and can even treat the disease at times, actually, even without radiation therapy. So it allows the Gamma Knife to work, and then we actually can prevent disease from coming back over time and hopefully for a long time.
The lesions that we target with Gamma Knife, you know, either resolve fully or scarred down. And Dr. Jones's therapies, they're being effective. Other lesions that we didn't target are essentially gone, and we haven't seen any new lesions since.
And that's some good news in a journey filled with lots of ups and downs.
Everyone always told me when I was going through this that whenever they see me, that I always have a smile on my face. And I've always gone into it thinking, kind of, you can be bitter or you can be better. And I guess I always, like, try to focus on living